don't even know about it. I wrote this letter to my baby. On my way, I passed it.
So true. How how I wish I had you. I'm so glad I love you. Mr. Reese Wise, Mr. Chief Tommy Shannon, Chris Slayton, I'm me. We all thank you for coming and supporting such a serious thing.
Named Musician of the Year at the recent National Blues Awards in Memphis, Tennessee. He has played to sold-out houses on three continents, including at Carnegie Hall and the Sydney Opera House. He is a Grammy Award winner. He's the only musician ever to have played the national anthem at the Houston Astrodome. And for his charity work, he's been made an honorary admiral in the Texas Navy. And yet once, Stevie Ray Vaughan was just another kid at home driving his parents crazy, playing the guitar all the time. And we're here today to talk to Stevie Ray Vaughan about how you go from being a kid at home driving your parents crazy to being one of the most respected musicians in the world. True or false? Did your parents say, put down that guitar and do your homework?
No, they said maybe turn it down sometimes, you know.
When did you fall in love with the guitar?
Immediately.
When did you first hear it? Did you hear the Beatles on the radio when you were a kid or something?
Yeah,
like that?
I listened to a lot of the radio broadcasts out of Chicago and Nashville that were record marts, and they would have a lot of different types of music. It would be gospel, blues.
Is this lying in your bed at night, Stevie, with the little transistor radio?
Yeah, you got it.
Every musician has this. It's not true.
Hey, it's true, though. It's true. It's something to do.
When did you first lay your hands on a guitar, and could you do anything with it right away?
Nobody can do something with it right away, I don't think, besides maybe my brother. He didn't seem to have learned. He just seemed to start playing. I was about 7, I guess, when I first started picking up his guitars that he was saying to leave alone. He was doing it on purpose. You know?
It hurts your fingers the first time you pick it up, right?
Sometimes. Yeah, a lot of people it does. It's something that doesn't either bothers you or doesn't bother you. You keep going.
Do you remember the first tune you learned how to play? And if so, I'm going to ask you to play it. Do you remember what you used to do?
The first thing I tried to learn was, you know, more like
you know.
Little walking blues, but you were trying. You were trying.
Yeah, I was doing my best.
You are a blues musician, and you don't take that title lightly, and yet I think that term is very misunderstood, isn't it?
Yes, it's really, the blues are music that soothes, and they've been responsible for a lot of other type of music to be here in the first place. Rock and roll is just a baby of the blues, so is jazz.
Is it possible that a pop tune can become a blues tune just through coloring it?
Sure, the way you play. And it's like you said earlier, it's blues, you don't write them down on paper, you write the notes down to a song. But the tones and the way you feel them is the music itself.
Can you take a pop tune, maybe anything that's running around in your head, show me how to play it straight, and then show me how you put feel into it?
Well, to be honest, I like to play with feeling every time I play.
Okay, show me how you put feeling into a note.
Well, it depends. It depends on how you want to do it. You can like caress it, or you can sting it, you know.
More gentle, a little more wistful.
Yeah.
Really, so much human emotion. Do you feel that emotion when you're playing, the emotion that those notes suggest to me?
If I didn't, I shouldn't be there.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When did you start to feel it, though? Because when you're a kid, it's just, you don't have grown-up emotions.
Well, you feel it first, and then you learn how to do it.
Hat mir nicht nur der Hut imponiert, sondern auch viel mehr die Gitarre. Es ist ein Künstler, vor dem ich schlicht und ergreifend Hut abmachen kann. Und besser noch als der Hut ist
the Stevie Ray Vaughan aus Texas.
Stevie.
Yeah, excuses for stealing your hat. I mean, but you know, we have to have a little gag. Is that a brand new guitar here?
Actually, it's a 1959 Stratocaster.
Also, es ist eine ziemlich alte Gitarre. Die sieht auch nicht neu aus, aber vielleicht können wir sie mal sehen, ja?
Why does it look so harsh? I mean, do you use it for other purposes?
No, I just play it right.
Er braucht also nicht für seine Gitarre nicht für andere Dinge. Er spielt nur drauf, aber er spielt ziemlich hart. Deshalb sieht sie wirklich aus wie abgebrannt, Stevie.